Hey everyone, surrealcanine here. Welcome back for more Disgaea 3, Absence of Detention. In this, the final episode, we are going to go do a thing. And by a thing, I mean this thing. Got a whole bunch of characters here. 7 monsters left that we are going to demo today. And I should mention right off the bat that these 3 are only available by default in Absence of Detention. Factory Desco is a PS Vita exclusive, and these 2 here are DLC in Absence of Justice. Okay. Let's talk about zombie dragons. They got high attack and defense, very melee-focused units, although their move leaves quite a bit to be desired. They take half damage from physical, and their learnable abilities are Blood Insanity, which we've seen on Satina. More damage to units of low HP. Death Fang, which doubles damage to paralyzed targets, and Vendetta, which has a chance of death blow for counterattacks. Let's take him into action and see what's up. As you can see, he learns the shield skill, which I guess is a thing. And sorry if I'm not talking much, I don't really have a whole lot to say at this point. This game was pretty fun, but I'm kinda glad to be done with it. As much as I like this guy, I kind of got burned out and discouraged several times throughout the course of the Let's Play. Of course, it got a lot worse after you know who won the election, but never mind that. But anyway. Also, I should mention at this point that due to some technical difficulties with OBS, I might not be able to start Disgaea 4 right away. If I feel like Let's Playing at all by the time this goes up, I'm probably gonna do something else that I can record without needing to switch screens around and stuff. So make of that assertion what you will, I guess. I don't know. Let's see here. See that mana change.
All together, please.
Let's see, dragon's jawbone, we will make dragons of them. That doesn't sound right at all. My attempt at quoting Samson has fallen flat.
I will do my best.
So yeah, that's the zombie dragon. Alright, next up on the agenda, we have Greganhite, who is a wood golem. Wood golems are your the quintessential tank. I mean, look at that. Well, okay, the defense isn't quite as high as Taro. Well, I don't actually know that for sure, but yeah, look at that attack aptitude. That is a thing. I wasn't aware attack aptitudes got that high. I thought 155 was the max. Oh well. As you can see, he recovers HP at the end of the turn. He also recovers HP when he deals damage. Stats increase by 20 when HP is maxed out, and Fresh Green Sprout fully recovers on level up. Pretty great. You got slightly higher HP than these other guys. Well, except for her, but she's a much higher level too. Stats all around pretty okay. Elemental resistances, not so much. He doesn't learn magic either, so, yeah. But hey, he recovers HP, so, if you're not in the post-game where everybody can kill you in one hit, that's great. That's really great. Let's get out there and bust a cap.
Here I go!
Behold, medieval torture at its finest. Cannot get this area of effect right. Whoop-a-doop-a-doo. Herp-a-derp. It's the Phantom Stump Stampede. Always a wonderful thing to behold. Also, hi. Oop. Hugs tonight! Wood golems are apparently pro wrestlers. Good to know. Alright, let's see that, see that thing. And by a thing, I mean, the magic change. You are a fist. A very wooden fist. Morphing blow. That sprite looks so ridiculous. Like, completely rigid and stuff. It's a thing. Of course, I cannot imagine that this guy is any stranger to janky animations. I mean, look at this. He's like, he's the same pixel resolution as Rutil, in spite of being like 10 times the size. Anyway, yeah. kitty cat copter. Okay, next up we have the rifle demon. These guys are about as clear of a Doom reference as you can get. You've got an incredibly high attack range, pretty similar to guns. And if they attack without moving, then they attack twice. Element stats go way up when HP is under 25%. Star attack has extra power. Heavy stance cannot be lifted, but stats increase by 20%, so now we know where that came from. As for their magic, they have none. Let's go check out the thing with the thing with the thing, a thing. I am recording, right? Yes. I need to ask these questions because the last time I tried to record this, I forgot to hit record. And I had a sad. I'm gonna have to remember that guy for later.
Me too.
Boom. Extinctor cannon. Yep, definitely BFG levels of power there. Thing with the thing. I hope he doesn't. I hope Rutil doesn't get punched, because that would be bad. For the reason being that this guy, everybody has counterattacks. The ultimate maneuver of pain when you are wielding a lightsaber. Just press it against the thing and turn it on. Also, gee, thanks a whole bunch, Salvatore. You sure are a big help. Dang it. Well, whatever. Now we get to do this. Destructo Launcher. Fun for all the boys and girls. Get one this Christmas. Lasers. Everybody loves them, especially in the Toho. Where's Rutil?
Me too.
There she is.
Me too.
This guy, of course, turned into a giant.
Please be nice.
Why would you expect anything else? As for what exactly they can do, it's not a rocket punch, it's a launcher punch. Consistent terminology in the video game. Believe it or not, I sneezed on camera in my last take of this, too. Manual barrel. Do a barrel. It's a multi-stage plasma cannon. Awesome sauce. And then they all kind of just fall off. It burned up and re-entered the atmosphere on entry. All right, before we head back in there, let's fix up a club assignment here. Tommy, you can give way to this guy. There. That's all we need to do. Let's heal, I guess, though, because why not? Oh, yeah. Next up, we have the Ifrit, otherwise known as the Agni, otherwise known as all the other things. Attack increases by a number of criticals, pretty high attack power there. Energy Eater, 10% of damage dealt by normal attack, recovers SP. Excuse me. Flame's Blessing, more fire damage. Fire of Revenge, stats increased by 10% per ally unit defeated. Alright, now we've heard of that. Oh yeah, I forgot to see if, so I gotta stop doing that thing with my leg. It makes the microphone go all wonky. It's like, ugh. Well, I can't really do it intentionally. But, yeah. Anyway! Nope, okay. I was mistaken. You do not learn any magic either. You just learn a thing with the thing. Let's make you go kaboom. Boom, baby. Boom. Everybody boom. Heck yeah, it's a solid space. Fire Blast! It's a Pokemon attack! Except it's supposed to be shaped like the kanji for fire. It's not supposed to be shaped like a horseshoe. Get your references right, Mr. Video Game! I dare you! Chaotic Flare. Got more, anime-style attacks. You never have enough of those. Everybody likes a good combo.
Do it, dude!
Prings. They're kind of a thing. Oh no. It's a thing. We have Disc for Space Remains for recording 559 hours and 59 minutes. Pretty great. I can record all week long if I need to, except I can't because I have a full-time job. I'm sad.
I will do my best.
Anyway, you most likely turn into a sword. That's what I remember you turning into the last time.
All together, please!
Yes. The sword made of crystallized fire. How does that work? Classical elements. They are classics for a reason. Flare Circle, let's see a thing. That's not so much a circle as an attack from all sides. But, you know, details. Hi, Thursday.
Yeah.
Spin, robot, spin! Relieve the stress of tomorrow! What does that even mean? I don't know. Also, I'm being dumb. Oh well.
Me too!
Alright, now that bit of stupidity is over and done with, let's say hi to the Nekomata! It's a kitty cat warrior. Meow.
Look at that stripes, I'm doing the kitty! Get to see kitties, oh boy!
Got special counter, which lets you, it's exactly what it says on the tin. Cross counter, increase the damage for counter attacks. Surprise attack, increase damage when you're dispatched from the base panel by 20%. Fatal counter, increase the damage of counter attack when HP is critical. Pretty nice. They got things. No magic, but they learn a couple of other things, which is pretty great. By other things, I mean the same 6 attack slots that all the other monsters get. It's nothing that's all that special, really. Cat martial arts skill number 1! Knee of Justice! Heck yeah. Everybody do do do, everybody do do do, everybody do 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 do. Cat Lady's Punch Out. Starring Cat Lady. Featuring Cat Lady. The meowest thing ever. I don't know. I can't talk right. There's a kitty on the screen. Martial arts skill final. Mystical teleporting anime kung fu attack. Overly intricate combination. The references are far and abound. Dragons! They're dragons. Need I say more? Increase offense per hit. Resets at attack. Inflict damage against bosses times 50%. I totally butchered that description, but I don't care. Increase equipment bonus when emblem is equipped. Increase stats by 50%, but specials are sealed. So, yeah. Kind of a mistranslation there, really. But yeah, don't equip that if you want to use your special attacks, because it'll seal them right up, and it ain't nothing you can do about the do. But before that, let's talk about cats. Because I am Derp, the king of Derp. Fear my derp. Look upon my derpsy mighty and despair, because I'm such a derp.
Me too!
Kitty cat magic changes to a sword. Got cat scratch. It It's a cat scratching the chalkboard. Much auditory pain. Cat paw! Dance with the kitty! Boy, the stripes, do you want to dance? She is not looking amused.
I'm keeping her awake,
because I'm so loud.
Boo-hoo, the kitty. It's the meow kitty. Hello, meow. Are you a meow?
I really did not need to do that, but whatever. Alright, anyway, back to dragons. Dragons. They're pretty great. I don't know why they're great. They're dragons. That's why they're great. Ain't nothing more awesome than a dragon. I rest my case.
I will do my best.
Is this okay? Said the explorer right before it got vacuumed up by Bowser. It totally is Bowser. And then there was Pooh. It should have been an egg, but I guess they didn't want to get sued by Nintendo. Nobody wants to get sued by Nintendo. Least of all, Nintendo. Blazing Breath! They do the finger gun thing while they are, doing a thing. It's very bizarre. Whatever. Dragon, he can do whatever he wants.
Hello, kitty. How are you doing? That was a good jump.
Ultimate dragon skill that destroys all! Yep.
Me too.
Magichain, what will you be? Good question. It's a spear. Spear with the blade coming out of the dragon's mouth. That's gotta be painful. Dragon Flash. Four panels away, we get a thing. Double kill! Except she turns out to be okay, because that's just how she rolls. Beat wash. What does that even mean? Very generic, let me tell you something. But, you know, alright. Fair enough, whatever. Finally, we have Factory Desco. Who you unlock by, not by doing that. You unlock by unlocking the real Desco and then passing the bill as Mao. Usatako Charge. KOing a unit, recover HP and SP. Special treatment! Magic change with anybody! Mana scarcity. Decrease mana but increase attack power. Three transformations. Increase stats by 50% when HP hits 2/3 and 1/3. Very final boss-esque. You will notice that Factory Desco learn star magic all the way up to the Terra level. This is pretty great, for reasons I will not mention, but they should be pretty obvious upon a moment's meditation. Let's go, Nancy, the fake Desco. Final boss arises. Got quite a couple of attacks just flat out stolen from Desco here. Which I guess makes sense because they're all clones of her. Yeah, that happened, but what if it hadn't happened? What then? Hi, Prinny. You are very upset with me, I can tell. Mini Desco decoy! I am Desco, Desco! It's a thing. True godly weapon. The return of Golden Sun Judgment. Sounds like a subtitle, but it is not. It's the name of an attack. As anybody who watched my earlier Let's Plays would know. Also, hi. You get bit by Valorous. How's that? Finally, we have final boss Rondo. Rondo of Blood. What the heck just happened? I do not think I want to know, nor does the internet at large. Well, maybe the internet, but not the rest of the world.
Please be nice.
It's a thing! It's an axe! It's Desco! The axe! Factory Desco's attacks are identical to regular Desco. So let's just watch the animations and then conclude this silly charade.
Please be my friend.
Epic laser asteroid storm destroyer. Yeah. Let's finish off this other guy, and you know, with that, the game is pretty much complete at this point. I mean, still a whole bunch of enemy animations and stuff I have yet to unlock. So many items I missed, but who cares? We did everything I set out to do. So, that being said, thank you all for watching, and instead of talking a whole bunch more, I'm just going to let you guys read the character bios as I meditate very quietly on what this video game was all about. Don't really have a lot to say at this point. I think the localization here is mistaking segregation with discrimination. Ask a whole bunch of people from 60 years ago, they would probably know. Or maybe not, I don't know. Segregation is what you do to your laundry if you don't want to drain all the color out of it. Point is, everybody is racist in another world, I guess. Whoops. Bushi Road, the only time I have ever heard it translated as such. Thank you. misuse of the word there. Oh no, it's the war of the artificial Descos. yeah. Well, I've been recording for about 45 minutes now. It's quite a long time to record, but there was a lot of stuff to talk about and read and stuff. But, yeah. Guess we'll be saying goodbye to this game for a very long time. Unless a thing comes out on the PC that makes me want to come back to this, I don't know. But yeah, see you guys in the next game, whatever I decide that's going to be. Thank you all for watching. Bye-bye.